everyone, welcome to our video class section of plus 2 biology. Today we are starting a new chapter. Our chapter name is reproduction in organism. Reproduction is defined as it is a biological process in which the organism gives rise to young ones similar to itself. Okay, so it shows a cycle of birth, growth and death. So the reproduction is a characteristic feature of all organisms for the continuation of the species. Reproduction is not a life process. It is a biological process. Okay. So why it is not a life process? Because without reproduction, the organism can live. Okay. So the processes the organism needed for maintaining their life, that is known as life processes. But here the reproduction is for continuing their generation or continuing their species. That occur only through the reproduction. That's why it is known as biological process. Clear it is. So this reproduction is mainly two types, asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. So in this chapter we are discussing the different methods of sexual reproduction and the asexual reproduction. Okay, so here I am giving the pictures of some organism. Okay, so all these organism having different lifespan. Different lifespan means, suppose elephant, the lifespan of elephant is 65 to 70 years, and for the rose plant 6 to 10 years. Okay, and for the dog 20 to 22, and butterfly 1 to 2 weeks, crow 15 years, banana tree 4 to 6 months, maybe 10 to 5 months, some varieties will be there, 10 to 5 months. Okay, then cow 10 to 20 years, parrot 140 years, then the crocodile 60 years, horse 6 to 62 years, then the fruit fly 15 to 30 days. So the organism having the lifespan, the period between the birth and the natural death. Okay, the period between the birth and the natural death of an organism is the lifespan. Lifespan of organism varies from few minutes. So what is the example for the organism having few minutes? In case of bacteria, okay, so it will live for some minutes. Then some organism will live for 100 years. Okay, for example, was that banyan tree, peepal tree, and some belongs to several thousand years. Example for that group is redwood trees. Okay, so there are organisms with extremely short lifespan and extensively long lifespans. The two forms of organisms are available or seen in our nature, one with short lifespans, few days, and other with few thousand years. So there is no correlation between lifespan and the body size. Clear it is. There is no correlation between the lifespan and the body size. Okay, so one can observe the wide difference in the lifespan of a crow and the parrot, even though there is not much difference in their size. The crow, the life period of the crow is 15 years and for the parrot is 140 years. So the looks like the crow and parrots are similar in size. Clear it is. So organism having different lifespan. So what is lifespan means? The period between the birth and the natural death of the organism. The period between the birth and natural death of an organism is known as lifespan. Okay, so here I am written the lifespan of some organism. First one is rose plant. For rose plant 6 to 10 years. For cow 10 to 20, dog 20 to 22, butterfly 1 to 2 weeks, elephant 65 to 70, then tortoise 100 to 150, crocodile 60, horse 60 to 62, crow 15 years, parrot 140 years, banana tree 10 to 15 months, rice plant 4 to 6 months, and banyan tree 200 to 300 years. Okay, the next is mode of reproduction. So the reproduction is mainly two types, asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Okay, what is the difference between this asexual reproduction and the sexual reproduction? In asexual reproduction, only one individual participants, and there is no formation and fusion of the gametes. In case of asexual reproduction, there occurs only the involvement of only one parent, and there doesn't occur the fusion of gametes. Okay, so this type of organism or this type of reproduction is known as asexual reproduction. But in case of the sexual reproduction, two parents are required. Okay, and the two parents are produce gametes, and the formation and the fusion of gametes occurs in sexual reproduction. So the mode of reproductions are mainly two types: asexual reproduction and the sexual reproduction. Clear it is. So here we are discussing the asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction are different types. Okay, so what is asexual reproduction? The young ones produced by asexual reproduction are genetically and morphologically identical. We can say they are the exact copies of the parents. Otherwise, we can say they are clones or copies. Okay, just as a photocopy. So the asexual reproductive organs are just as a photocopy or clones of their parent, both genetically and morphologically. So the type of asexual reproduction are fission, fragmentation, budding, vegetative propagation, regeneration, spore formation. All these are the different type of asexual reproduction methods. Clear it is. Asexual reproduction is common among various simple plants and animals. The common type of asexual reproduction are fission, sporulation. Sporulation means formation of spore. Okay, budding, fragmentation, zoospores, conidia, gametes, vegetative reproduction. All these are the types of asexual reproduction. Majority of the single cell organism exhibit fission. Fission means the parental body divides into different pieces. Okay, if the parental body divides into two pieces, that is known as binary fission. If the parental body divides into so many pieces, that are known as multiple fission. Clear it is? So first one is fission. We are discussing first one is fission. Okay, so the figure indicate, that's a figure of amoeba. In case of amoeba, the reproduction takes place by binary fission. The parent cell can divide into, the parental body divide into two equal halves. If the parental body divide into two equal halves, that is known as binary fission. If the parental body divide into two equal halves, that is known as binary fission. If the parental body divides into so many pieces, that is known as multiple fission. So this is the parent cell. So what happening here? First the nucleus divides into two, then the cytoplasm divides, then it will form a two daughter cells. Okay, so fission is an example for asexual reproduction. Fission taking place in amoeba. Don't forget, fission taking place in amoeba. In amoeba, which type of fission taking place? Amoeba. Binary fission will taking place in case of amoeba. Clear it is? Then another example is multiple fission. Multiple fission occurs in plasmodium. Multiple fission occurs in plasmodium. Binary fission occurs in amoeba. Multiple fission occurs in plasmodium. The parental body divides into so many pieces. So nucleus also divided and cytoplasm also getting divided. So multiple fission example plasmodium, and the binary fission example amoeba. What is fission? It is the division of the parental body into two or more daughter individuals. That is known as fission. Clear? Next is fragmentation. Fragmentation. Next one is fragmentation. Fragmentation means pieces. Okay. So here also the parental body divide into different pieces. Okay. Suppose this is a picture of hydra. So in case of first picture, this is a hydra's picture. So this second picture, what will happen? In middle of this hydra get splitted or fragmented. Okay. So this head portion produces the tail portion, and the tail portion will be produced the head portion. So this, from this two organs, the next two organs will be forming. Okay. So that is fragmentation. Clear it is? Fragmentation means the parental body divides into different pieces, and each piece produces the lost part. The body of organism breaks into small pieces or fragments, which later become new organism. That is known as fragmentation. So the fragmentation is taking place in hydra, then alga, fungi and protonema of the moss plant also. This fragmentation process will take place. Clear? Alga, fungi, protonema of most plant, and hydra. Next is gemmules. Okay, next one is gemmules. We studied this gemmule in plus one classes. Okay, gemmule is a small group of cells enclosed by a protective coat formed in sponges. That is known as gemmule. What are sponges? Sponges are included in the group Porifera. Porifera is a type of invertebrates. The body contain full of pores. Okay, so they are otherwise known as sponges. So a small group of cell is enclosed by a protective coat formed in sponges, that is known as gemmule. These gemmules are totipotent. Okay, so totipotent means they have the ability to produce any type of cells. Okay, so the gemmules contain totipotent cells. The type of totipotent cells present in gemmule, that is known as archaeocytes. Clear it is? The type of totipotent cells present in gemmule, that is known as archaeocytes. On liberation from the gemmule, the archaeocytes germinates to form new sponges. So the gemmules is a the group of cells which are covered by a protective coat, that is known as gemmules. Gemmules are common in sponges. So in case of gemmules, they contain a lot of totipotent cells. So each totipotent cells are known as archaeocytes. On liberation from the gemmule, each archaeocytes have the ability to produce new sponges. Okay, example for this group is all sponges are included in this group. So here I gave you one example, that is Spongilla. Spongilla is an example for the production of gemmule group. Clear it is? So the next is zoospores. The next one is zoospores. Zoospores we studied in zoospores and conidiophore, that also we studied in plus one. Okay, in when we studied biological classification chapter, we studied zoospores and conidiospores. What is zoospores? Zoospores are flagellated. If the spores having flagella, they have the ability to motile. That means moving. Okay. Zoospores. What are spores? Spores have the ability to withstand unfavorable condition. Spores have the ability to withstand unfavorable condition. The spores are microscopic, single-celled. Microscopic, single-celled, thin or thick-walled. Okay, thin or thick-walled. Microscopic, single-celled, thin or thick-walled. Then the zoospores motile and also flagellated. Example for the zoospores group is Chlamydomonas. Chlamydomonas is an example for zoospores. Okay, so zoospores, they are flagellated, formed inside the sporangium. So the spores are producers inside or the outside. Okay, if the spores are produced inside, that is known as endospores. Endospores. Okay, and the spores are produced outside, that are known as exospores. So here the zoospores are example for the endospores. So type zoospore is an also an example for the asexual reproduction. The next one is conidiophores. Conidiophores. Okay, so conidium is a non-flagellated. Conidium is a non-flagellated. It having a thick wall. Okay, formed at the tip of conidiophores. Formed at the tip of conidiophores, and they are produced exogenously. Exogenously means the spores are produced outside. Okay, so all these zoospores and conidiospores are plus one topic. If you having a doubt in this portion, just go through the biological classification chapter. Okay, zoospores and conidiospores. So what is spores? Spores are microscopic, single celled, or thin or thick walled. Okay, the zoospores are endogenous and conidiophores are conidiophores are exogenous. Conidiophores are not flagellated. Clear it is? So the next type of asexual reproduction is budding. Okay, so bud means daughter individual is formed from a small part of bud. This bud is arising from the parental body. Clear? Bud is an outgrowth, external outgrowth, that is not known as a bud. So from this bud or a small part, a new daughter organism will be forming. Offsprings here, genetically we are calling offsprings, and here in case of asexual reproduction, we are calling it is a daughter. Okay, so don't confuse with the daughter and son. Here in this asexual reproduction aspects, the offsprings are termed as daughter. Okay. So daughter individuals is formed from a small part or bud. So these buddings are occurs exogenous budding and endogenous budding. Exogenous means exo means outside. The bud grows externally on the surface of the parent body. Okay, the bud grows externally on the surface of the parent body and it may split away from the parent body. That is known as exogenous budding. Hydra is an example for exogenous budding. Okay, in case of yeast also, yeast is just a fungus. In case of yeast also, the bud is formed on outside and the newly formed the bud is, when the newly formed the bud get mature, it get detached from the parent body and lead a separate life. Okay, so in case of budding, there occur unequal division. Then endogenous budding means the buds are formed within the parent body. The buds are formed within the parent body that are called endogenous budding. Okay, they are called gametes, which consisting of a smaller group of cells in protective covering. Okay, we already studied gamete. So this is another concept that the type of budding is two type, exogenous budding and endogenous budding. Endogenous buddings are always known as gametes. Okay, then the third type of budding is strobilation. Strobilation, the repeated formation of similar segments by the process of budding is called strobilation, and the segmented body is called strobila. Okay, this occurs in the case of Aurelia larva, jellyfish. Okay, so what is strobilation? The repeated formation of similar segments. Repeated formation of similar segments by the process of budding called strobilation, and the segmented body is called strobila. Okay, so we discussed different types of asexual reproduction method. The first we discussed fission. Fission is the division of parent body into two or more pieces. Okay, so it may be a binary fission or a multiple fission. Binary fission example amoeba, multiple fission example plasmodium. Next we discuss fragmentation. The parental body get divided into different fragments and each fragments develop into a new organism. Okay, if the parental body divides into different pieces and they have the ability to produce the lost part, that condition is regeneration. The planaria, we studied that this name in plus one chapter, plus planaria, and the hydra can also produce by regeneration. So the another term of this fragmentation is regeneration. Fragmentation means each fragments can be produced into new organism. Regeneration means they have the ability to produce the lost part. The lizards cutting their tail on the in some situation. Okay, so they have the ability to produce the tail again. So that's the type of a regeneration. Here the in case of hydra, what will happen in they can produce any part, okay, any part from the body. That is known as regeneration. Okay, the formation of whole body from a small fragment, that is known as morpholaxis. Formation of whole body, full body from a small fragment, formation of whole body, that is known as morpholaxis. Clear it is. Fission, fragmentation, regeneration. In case of regeneration, the next term is morpholaxis. What is morpholaxis? The whole body is formed from a small fragment, that is known as morpholaxis. Okay, so example is hydra. Next we discussed gametes. Gametes is a protective, some of cells are covered by a protective layer. It occurs in the spongilla. Then the next is budding. The buds are produced, exogenous buds and the endogenous buds. Buds are the outgrowth of the body. So the organism can produce exogenous budding and the endogenous budding. Sometimes repeated formation of similar segments by the process of budding are called strobilation. The segmented body is called strobila. Okay, So this occurs in case of Aurelia, otherwise known as jellyfish. The next is spores. Spores are microscopic, single celled and thick-walled. Okay, thin or thick-walled. They are asexual parts. Okay, so spores have the ability to withstand unfavorable condition. The spores are two types, exospores and endospores. So some spores are motile and other are non-motile. All motile spores having flagella for motility. Okay, so zoospores are motile and the conidia spores are non-motile spores. Clear it is? So we study different type of asexual reproduction methods and study the lifespan of different organisms. Here I am discussing some important questions from the previous year. Okay, so the first question is, what is lifespan? What is lifespan? You just recollect what I am telling in the lifespan portion. What is lifespan? The period from birth to natural death. Birth to natural death of an organism, that is termed as lifespan. Clear it is? Then write the lifespan of butterfly, tortoise, parrot, crocodile. I gave you one column. Okay. So, correctly, you are not down all the column. Rose plant, how much year, crocodile, how much year, like this. Okay. Write in your notebook. Then the butterfly, in case of butterfly, the lifespan is 1 to 2 weeks. In case of tortoise, 100 to 150 years. Parrot, 140 years, and crocodile 60 years. Okay, sequoia plant can live 3000 to 4000 years. Lifespan of sequoia plant is 3000 to 4000. Okay, then the oldest living tree is bristlecone pine tree. They can live 4600 years. 4600 years. Bristlecone pine tree. Okay. Then name the most important characteristics of plant and animal. So in this concept, you are telling reproduction. Reproduction only a biological process. It is not a life process. Okay. How do lower organisms reproduce? Lower organisms are reproduced by cell division or by budding. Clear it is. What term is used for the progeny of asexually reproducing organisms? What is the term? Asexually reproducing organism, the term for the progeny. Okay, so the term for the asexually reproducing organism, the term is clone. Clone means just photocopy, exact copy. Genetically and such morphologically and genetically similar individuals are known as clones, and clones are just exact copy of their parents. So the asexual reproduction offsprings, that means daughter individuals, are just as clone. Okay, so the next is, how do yeast reproduce? Yeast reproduce by budding. Okay.